Zvezda means star,
yes.
And Liki is face.
Yes, like to see the
face. Basically, it means star face. Also, it means
monarch,
the king of the stars.
Yes.
Le roi des étoiles.
Yeah, very fierce.
And it's not stars like people.
Vedettes, suits.
With attitudes.
No, not primitives. Astral.
But it's more like astrophysics
or theosophy.
The universe.
Yes, zodiac. Who are you and what else have you done?
We started in the Norwegian church,
yes.
Near Italië in Antwerp. Basically, it was just at that moment not a very overthought idea. It was just spontaneous, like, hey, let's do a concert here and we'll see what happens after.
Yeah.
But there was such nice acoustics there.
Yes.
Now, these days, the chapel is closed,
yes.
It's gone. Been sold to a company, so yeah, but it felt so good to do your own thing,
yes,
and experiment a bit with sound and playing together,
yes.
Yeah, also experiment a little bit with the acoustics,
yes.
So that I decided this is kind of cool to do, nice, also interesting,
yes.
Inspiring, also challenging because I think I need that,
yes.
As a person, that it just gradually always kind of continued by itself.
Yes.
Sometimes I think, oh, okay, now I'm kind of stuck, but then always something happens that pushes it forward.
Yes.
So there's always new things coming, you meet new people, there's new ideas, new possibilities, new places, new countries, there's always something pushing it.
Yes. In which ways does Zvezdoliki stay consistent whilst somehow advancing, as well as actually evolutionary?
Well, I think the basic idea has been consistent. It's like, go your own way. That's the main road, I think.
Yes.
It's been evolutionary because there's been a lot of different formations,
yes.
Since the beginning. Sometimes there were five people, sometimes there were three. Last time when we did the Buenos Aires, there were 15 people.
Yes.
So that's the kind of thing that constantly changes.
Yes.
It also depends on possibilities and chances,
yes.
Or people, or so you just adjust a bit to what's around you,
yes.
To get things done.
Yeah.
Yeah, the way we work is quite unique, I think.
Yes.
We're not the kind of ensemble that always stays with the same constellation.
No. Yes.
But in different form, like some,
yes.
Kind of chameleon.
Just chameleon act. Yes, chameleon act.
Adjusting to
flexibility.
To your surroundings.
Yeah. Adaptation.
Or to the things that come to you, or the things you go after, and then you see what you can do.
Flexibility, yeah. Adaptation.
Yes.
And perhaps having some form of influence or effect or consequence.
I think we surely do. Yes.
Yes. Impact.
Maybe a bit
legacy.
Too modest in it to give much detail about it, but I think the way we work and the road we make.
Yes.
I think
not just follow, but
it's very challenging but also unique. Yes.
Yes. Mm. How do you consider or even know Zvezdoliki to be now?
Now, I think I'm mainly preparing the future.
Yes.
It's been a really crazy year.
Yes.
2020. Yes. The mad year.
Yes.
So.
It wasn't a non-event or a disaster. It seemed to be. It actually was an unbelievably mixed and very active and.
Yes. But also
never
it was
moment, yeah.
A year that gave time to think like maybe we can make some adjustments, maybe
yes.
We can make new projects. There were some new projects.
Yes.
Originated during the lockdown.
Yes.
Now it's mainly focus on what can we do next.
Yes.
So there's a lot of ideas growing slowly, 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 contacting people to work with. It's always quite a big build-up,
yes.
Before it is actually there.
Yes.
So there's actually three big projects coming up, which I can't, of course, tell much about yet. So it's going to be new music,
yes.
And new concepts also. Also a bit more focus on this. On
yes.
Food. Which is a shame because it's a fantastic piece and it exactly describes the way I imagine the universe.
Yes.
There's a lot of space and undefined it.
Yes.
And also the colors, and almost actually in the piece you can even see the stars.
Yes.
As I imagine the universe to be or sound or look like.
Yes.
Лицо его было как солнце, в тот час, когда солнце в зените. Глаза его были как звезды, пред тем, как сорваться с небес. И краски из радуг служили, как ткани, узоры и нити для пышных его одеяний, в которых он снова воскрес. Кругом него рдянились громы в обрывных разгневанных тучах, и семь золотых семизвездий, как свечи, горели пред ним. И гроздья пылающих молний цветами раскрылись на кручах. Хранители слова, он молвил. Мы крикнули с воплем «Храним!». Я первый умрёк и последний. И гулко ответили громы. Час жатвы, сказал Звездоликий, серпы приготовьте, аминь. Мы верной толпою восстали, на небе аллели изломы, и семь золотых семизвездий вели нас к пределам пустынь.